One of our most popular exhibits is Lawrence of Arabia's Cloak and Dagger. They are located in our Army Gallery, and we acquired them back in 2016, actually for the reopening of the museum. So it was one of our big stories when we reopened. The other object that we have that also hadn't been on display before our redevelopment project was Wellington's Cloak, which is up in our Battle Gallery next door to Marengo, who is Napoleon's horse. So the Special Forces exhibition here at the National Army Museum is the first ever paid for exhibition we've done. It is proving to be very, very popular, and there are lots of people coming. The new National Army Museum is a very different proposition to the old museum. It is not only lighter and brighter, but we are now thematic instead of chronological. We're here to provide a debate. We want to provide people with facts. We don't want to tell them what is right or wrong, and we want them to form their own opinions when they leave the museum. The story of the army is obviously portrayed here, but it's also the story of British history and how the army might influence your lives in ways you don't realise, from films to music to fashion.
Special Forces, I was here on the opening weekend and it was quite busy. It's been quite constant in people coming through from 10 a.m. to 4:30.
I think one of the greatest values is that people should reflect on the military generally, and in this case the army, as being supportive of a group of people, and that's us as a nation. And not just out there fighting wars, but actually doing quite a lot of other stuff as well.
There's a lot of information here. It's not all boring for children. It covers loads of different things, not just your hardcore army stuff.
It's not just the facilities, which is really user-friendly for children and mothers and fathers, but also you've got space here so that you can relax in between going in and out of different exhibits.
With our rebranding, we actually went out to a family audience and specifically wanted more families to come into the museum, and that's something we've seen has vastly increased. We are incredibly busy over the holidays and half terms, and our biggest numbers sort of over the past 2 years have actually fallen over the Easter weekend.